Cartoonist Garry Trudeau has written one of 8 competing pilot episodes posted online by Amazon. His is called Alpha House.
Taylor had another stroke last night. He withdrew from the race.
What? That's good. Well, not for him, obviously, but... Now, that's an outstanding development.
Uh-uh, honey bear. Guess who just announced he's running now?
Who?
Jigger Mancusi.
Huh?
You're in a real race now, darling. You can't just sit in your little man cave anymore waiting to be reelected.
Son of a... That's an iPhone. Who smashes an iPhone?
I sat down with the creator of Doonesbury in New York.
Garry Trudeau, welcome.
So happy to be here.
You're a professional cartoonist. Why'd you want to make an online video pilot?
I had to be persuaded, especially the online part. I'm not a newcomer to television. I've done a special and some pilots and in a couple of series, but I did have to be talked into this.
Doing it for Amazon.
Exactly.
Does that mean that TV is over and this is the new television?
Well, they had only been doing it for 3 or 4 months. It was a kind of a pop-up studio, and they decided they wanted to get into the content business, and because they're Amazon, they could do it quickly. And they came up with a different model, which is if we're going to spend all this money creating television shows, shouldn't we know a little bit about whether the audience actually wants to watch them? And so they said, here's the deal. You can come and make a pilot for us, but we're going to put it on, you know, we're going to hang it up online. And
American go like
this? Yeah, exactly.
Or like this.
And so who wants to be troll bait? I mean, it wasn't something that appealed to me enormously originally, but then I thought about it, and the process is actually, given the capability Amazon has for capturing very nuanced data, the process gives them more information about whether they should be making this show. And it's transparent, it's democratic, it's rational. It's not just people with gut feelings in executive towers in L.A.
Well, the people who voted don't necessarily have the final say, but obviously it's a major factor. So you're up against 7 other pilots by smart people.
Right.
A little nervous about this bake-off?
Well, they tried to discourage a competitive mindset with all of us. They said, if you guys make 8 great pilots, we'd love to put 8 great shows on the air. So that was never the dynamic as we understood it. Now that may in fact be complete BS, but
I always thought the pilots were expensive to make. You've got John Goodman, you've got Bill Murray. Did they owe you a favor or something?
John Goodman, no one was more surprised than I that he got involved a year ago. I don't think anybody of that stature was running towards making online programming.
Then came Netflix and Kevin Spacey, and now it's.
I think that was a
thing.
That was a big game changer. But I also think that he just liked the project, and he decided in 2 days. And we didn't get the pushback that I imagined we would all across the board with cast and crew. Everybody. No one blinked. No one said, "Oh no, this is web. We're not doing this." And so we got some very talented people from the film world and television world to jump in.
So I'm going to accuse you of having a cynical view of Washington, because you've got this congressional group house and you've got a senator who considers going to Afghanistan just to make sure he can get himself reelected, and then you've got a Latino lover type lawmaker, and then you have an anti-gay lawmaker who goes and gets an award from the Council for Normal Marriage.
Right.
Is that how you view our nation's capital?
Well, as you didn't say, all 4 of them are Republicans, and they do share this house. This is based on an actual house that Chuck Schumer and others have shared for years. And the reason they're Republican and is actually a dramatic one. It's a creative one. It's not so much an ideological one. The Republicans are under a great deal of pressure. The 3 of the 4 senators were elected prior to the Tea Party, so the game has changed considerably. They're defending themselves from the right.
So you're saying it's in service of the plot, liberal Garry Trudeau's jaundiced view of the GOP?
It is. The previous 2 shows I did, Tanner and Tanner on Tanner, both were about liberal Democrats. One, a candidate who was running for president, and the other was a liberal do-good filmmaker. And I go to where I think I can make the story the most interesting. In the late 80s, the Democrats were in the wilderness.
Right.
And while I did give Tanner initially a very, what I hoped, a soul-stirring speech at the beginning of the series. I'm no Aaron Sorkin. I don't do admirable people.
All right, you made that clear.
You were on Twitter for a while, and you were hysterical, and then you dropped out. Too risky being funny every day in 140 characters?
Not so much risky as it was really time-consuming. I mean, I just fell into the black hole. You tweet, so you know.
A lot, and it is time-consuming.
You know the danger.
I miss you on there.
Well, it was, I mean, for me, it was work. It wasn't just a pastime. I was trying to create comedy haiku. I was trying to actually write good tweets.
Okay, you just made it look effortless. Now,
well, that's the goal.
The Doonesbury strip began in 1970. How have you managed to keep it fresh and relevant and keep yourself interested in running a comic strip?
Well, I'm a curious guy, and I just kind of follow my curiosity. I dive into the news, as I'm sure you do every morning, and it never ceases to intrigue me and fascinate me and draw me in. So there's never any danger of fatigue in that sense. Also, because I write characters who age in real time,
right,
I have a multi-generational viewpoint. And I find myself favoring the younger characters, as you might imagine, because younger characters are always in the process of becoming. They're not set in their ways, and their behavior isn't as predictable.
But you have a lot of fun with the aging and intrepid journalist Roland Burton Headley III.
I do. I have a lot of characters I can cast that are appropriate to any particular situation.
Right. Now, a while back, you had Zonker and one of the other characters make a plea for newspapers. Now, we can read Doonesbury online, but obviously it started out as a newspaper strip. It's still a newspaper strip. Why did you feel so passionately as to have them say, folks, don't abandon the print press?
Well, it's not because of any reluctance to go online myself. I've been online since 1995, so it's was creating CD-ROMs and did an early webisode show called Duke 2000 about 13 years ago. So I embrace the web fully,
but
I'm a newspaper guy. That's where I started. I still read newspapers, the physical newspaper every morning. You're always a product of what you came of age within, and I love newspapers. So
I have to confess, I'm the same way.
So I'll be one of those guys who probably turns out the lights, you know.
Garry Trudeau, thanks for sitting under the lights here with us today.
Oh, my great pleasure. Thank you.